Yay! I want to go outside in it, but I can't because I've got a child to take with me.
Hello and welcome to day number 104, which is day number 8 of the Mary's Mini. Now, I'm, gonna disclose this. I am actually recording this on the Tuesday morning. Basically, it got to about 10 o'clock last night. Me and Sigurta had got Rowan ready for bed. Sigurta was ready for bed. And I was just sat there saying, do you know, it's been such a long time since I had a lie-in and it's too warm. I'm feeling ridiculously, ridiculously tired. I'm going to go to bed and I'm going to wake up early and record the vlog. So it's currently about 9 a.m. our time in Germany. So I'm going to count that as still like on the day. Because, like, you know, certain parts of America are still, you know, it's still before midnight. Yeah, things have gone great today. Things have gone really, really good. What do I even want to talk about on this? Things have gone really, really good today. Like, it's been nice and easy and chilled out, and I'm just taking like a little bit of time to recover from all this running around that I did on Saturday still, which now is kind of feeling like a bit of an excuse, but I mean, like, it's been like 12 years, if not more, since I did anything to do with filming. And you know, it's kind of like the first day that I spent working retail. I'd never stood on my feet solidly for like 9 hours, 10 hours of the day before. You know, there's no seats when you're working in retail unless you're, you know, in a supermarket checkout. Then you get a little stool to sort of like perch on slightly, but it's still mostly wandering around. And that just ruined me for the first day that I ever did that. So filming and stuff, again, is just like, oh God, my legs, my feet, my back. I mean, like, even the seasoned professionals who were there are like, oh, my back's starting to get a bit tight now. Like, you know, you're constantly like trying to stand up straight and make sure that everything's done and you're lifting with best practice and stuff. Like, if you've got anything heavy and yeah. So even though it feels a little bit excusey, you know, I mentioned that I thought I was coming down with a cold, and I'm still in a complete quandary about it. Like, I have no idea. Like, recording this on Tuesday morning, like, yesterday, for the most part, I felt fine. But every now and again, like, my nose would fill up and I'd have to go and blow it. This morning, I've had to go and blow my nose a few times. And, you know, I haven't had water in a little while, so my throat's feeling a little bit scratchy as well. Like, not like a usual sort of like, oh, I haven't drank in, like, you know, half an hour, like it's actually like a little bit like, oh, there's a bit of texture there, let's say, you know, like it feels a little bit grainy, you're like, you know. So yeah, if I am coming down with a cold, this is the best I've felt coming down with a cold for decades. Man. I don't know. Yeah, there's been a couple of comments from people about things like that, like switching to whole food plant-based. There was one lady who commented who said, like, yeah, I switched to whole food plant-based and now colds just don't do much to me anymore. And I'm like, That is crazy to think about. It really is. So, I don't know. Like, hopefully it's something like that, where, you know, I've actually got myself to a point where I am actually healthy enough to just be like, ah, okay, look, cold, whatever, and carry on. Like, that would be awesome after years and years of just, like, feeling awful every time I get one. And I mean, like, pretty much having them constantly. Like, average length of a cold for me was, like, 6 weeks, you know? What was my nickname at my old work? At, like, the car insurance place, they had a nickname for me. And it was something like the plague or something like that, because I just constantly had colds, because, like, you're moving desks all the time and you're talking on a phone and stuff, like an old phone handset. Like, we didn't switch to headsets for a little while after I'd started working there, because people didn't like using them. And then we finally got new ones and everything was cool again. But, yeah, like, the handsets and stuff, like, everyone's, like, talking into them, you're getting other people's kids' germs, all the kids that their kids are hanging around with, their germs, everything. So I'm constantly, like, inhaling stuff and just could not get by at all. But yeah, like, it's all going well, apart from that. Like, the scale is moving still in a good downward direction. Or it was yesterday, anyway. Obviously, you're going to have to wait up until today's video for the weigh-in, you know. On day 9. Ah, yeah. Of course, today is day 8 recording. This is day 8 recording, so we're going to talk about day 8. Day 8 was actually pretty nice. It was ridiculously warm all day. I got up with Rowan fairly early on. We sat around in the living room. We played with a bunch of his building blocks, like his Duplos and stuff. Just like read books to him. He keeps on coming out with the occasional word now, and there's no rhyme or reason to which word it is. And it's never like the same word again. Like, he'll do it for one day and then that's it. Like, you never hear it again. So I think he's on the cusp of starting to, like, try and stitch things together a little bit, which is awesome for me, because the moment that he starts talking or starts, like, understanding that he can, you know, communicate and make himself understood, that's when I can actually start, like, being even, like even better with him than I think I currently am. Because at the minute, he says something, or he makes a noise, or he does something, and, like, I know roughly what he's after, but I don't know exactly. You know, like, I've got this massive hang-up, like, this massive mental hang-up where I'm just constantly beating myself up over it, saying, like, oh, God, like, am I not helping his growth? Am I, like, failing to give him, like, the social exposure that he needs by not having him in Akita? I'm trying to get him into Akita, and it's not like, it's not anything that I'm doing that's stopping me from getting him into Akita. It's just the situation over here. And it's completely, like, luck of the draw whether or not you get somewhere quick or don't get somewhere, or get something like 6 months after you moved in or 2 years after you moved in. You know, I mean, Saguta asked me the other day if I minded, like, do I just want to stop looking for Akita and just have Rowan with me up until he's 6? And I'm like, no. Like, he needs to be around other kids. He needs to have friends and like, learn to play and share and stuff. And I can only teach him that so much. And I don't want him to be, like, completely overwhelmed in social situations and stuff. Like, I want my son to be, like, good. I want my son to be, like well-adjusted. Not like this. You know? It's the normal hang-up that every parent has. Like, you always worry that you're not doing enough for them. or that you're doing too much for them and they're not going to learn. I'm so hopeful that like I can get him into Akita, because then he'll start learning German and he'll start learning interaction and playing with other kids and doing a whole bunch of stuff that I haven't been able to do with him yet. You know, like messy play stuff. Like, I don't mind like getting out some paints and letting him like splot around and stuff, but like along with that comes a lot of cleanup. And if it's just me in the house with him and there's a cat and both of them are trying to get back into the stuff that is messy while I'm trying to clean it up, it's not going to go very well. Like, bathing him as a like a one person operation is kind of difficult. Like, it's not impossible, but you know, he's strong now. He can you know, he can do things now that he couldn't do 6 months ago, like take off his own nappy. Little terror. He's been doing that a couple of times now, apparently. He's been like whipping it off, and then just you find him jumping around the living room, or like you look up from something and there he is, just completely butt naked for the world, doink, 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 bouncing around on the sofa. You know, put the nappy back on. Yeah, I don't know. Like, oh, how did we even get onto this conversation? I don't know. Right, okay, break of tangent. Like, let's stop that. Right, so, things are going good. Things are going fine. It's been really nice sitting around with Rowan, playing with Rowan, doing stuff. He went for a sleep around about lunchtime, like after he'd had his lunch, and just like went out for about an hour. I had my lunch, which was this, which I can't remember exactly what it was, but it was some sort of potato. And then he woke up and he came into the living room and he climbed up on me and he fell asleep. And he stayed asleep for another 3 hours. So evidently he was a very, very tired little boy. So yeah, that was fun for me. Like, I managed to extricate myself from under him, like slide out my arm and like get up and move around and stuff after about half an hour or so. And just had to sit in the living room quietly. I did catch up on some Lodi Randy Run stuff, some magic tournaments that they were playing on Twitch stream. I managed to watch the video for that. You know, it was just nice and quiet and chilled, and Rowan's asleep in one bit, the cat's asleep in the other. I'm just sat there, just, you know, vegetating. No, it was a nice day yesterday. And then, like, literally the moment that Rowan woke up, I said, right, we're going to go out, we're going to go to the shop, because we need to buy more nappies, because we're out of the size that he currently takes. And we are going to buy some extra vegetables and this and that. And we're going to get some stuff for Sigurta when she comes home, you know, so she can have some dinner. And no sooner had I said it than the heavens opened and produced the rain that you see in the opening of the video here, which is the first time it's rained in a couple of weeks, I want to say. It was glorious. It was so nice. Just having that bucketing down. Unfortunately, it didn't really take any of the heat out of the air. It just added more humidity. So if anything, it felt warmer at that point. It was, oh no. Sigurta came home completely drenched and her feet stained red, because when she went out in the morning, she wore her sandals, which have like red leather straps. And the rainwater hitting those and soaking them made the red leather seep out and dye her feet. So she took her shoes off and had this moment of horror where she thought, oh God, I'm covered in blisters. I didn't realize it was this bad. No, just red dye. So that was kind of funny. Rain had stopped at that point. So I threw on my clothes and my shoes and I went straight out the door and I went and bought a bunch of vegetables and bread and milk and, you know, all the usual bits and bobs that you end up needing midweek. Lots and lots of iced tea for Sigurta. I was definitely tempted by some stuff in the supermarket, like, but it was like, it was weird the things that I was tempted by. Like potato chips, like crisps. I was tempted by crisps purely because it was a different form of potato. Like, that's a weird reason to have a craving for something. Like, walking past the fruit section as well, like, I don't eat fruit that much. But man, did I want a banana. And like, just like weird little things. Like, I finally picked up some mustard. It's not exactly like the mustard that I'm used to. It's not like English mustard or yellow mustard, I guess you might call it. It's not like French mustard either, where it's like a grey liquid. It's sort of like a mix between French and Dijon, if you get the idea. So it's like a greyish mustard. It's a little bit lighter than grey mustard, a little bit lighter than French mustard. But like, it's got seeds and stuff in. And it's like a German farmer mustard. And I'm like, I'm willing to try that. Like, that seems like it might be interesting. But like, yeah, it's just that little bit different to stuff that I've had before, so I'm not entirely sure. I picked up some garlic aioli, which does have powdered egg white in it, or powdered egg, I think. So I can't have it. Unless it's like a cheat day. But like, I figure Sigurd is going to have it anyway. When I eventually have a cheat day, I'll be honest with you, I feel like having pizza. I don't know when that's going to be, but I do feel like having pizza. Like, I had this weird craving for pizza as well while I was wandering around the shop, because there's like freezers, like, you know, like the chest freezers? Chest freezer with like pizzas stacked in. And I was like, even just a four cheese pizza, with a bit of garlic aioli, a little bit of garlic sauce. Oh, yes. But, you know, like, stayed strong. Strong. Like, it actually, like, yeah, like, not having stuff these days, like, just, like, denying myself certain things that, like, I have this weird pang for, is so much easier now than at the beginning of all of this. Like, at the beginning, it felt difficult, you know? Like, now it doesn't feel that hard. You know, it's just like a part of my everyday, just being like, oh, that looks like it would be tasty. But no, I'm not allowed that. I mean, like, Saturday, the filming day, I just denied myself food the entire day long. Like, I wasn't particularly, like, over hungry or felt starving or anything. Like, it was just like, oh, well, this isn't what I'm allowed to eat. This isn't what I'm allowing myself to eat. It's not what I want to eat to stay true to the Mary's Mini and what I'm currently doing and my current goals. So I just didn't eat for a long time. So, yeah, I don't know. Is that personal evolution? Is that getting on with this sort of thing? Is that finally, you know, after all this time, learning self-control? Who knows? But anyway, so we've had all of that. Bought some stuff, as I say. I bought some things for Suguta. Had some weird... Hello! Cat. Yeah, so I went around the shop, I picked some stuff up, like, dealt with my weird little, like, hunger, desire, pang things. Came back home, and Sigurda cooked her stuff, which I can't remember what she had. Oh, yeah, did she just have sandwiches? Yeah, she just had, like, sandwiches and stuff. Rowan, she gave, like, a bunch of sandwich stuff to as well, which, you know, is fine. Like, you know, he doesn't eat much anyway. He's got a very tiny stomach. So, like, sandwichy stuff just fills him anyway. And then I had, you know, sort of, like, I wasn't really hungry at that point, so I just sort of, like, waited for a bit. And Sigurda came in here and she came back into the kitchen and she cooked this amazing banana caramelized sugar with pecan nuts thing and made cream and stuff. I was like, this looks amazing. This is an amazing looking dessert. I don't want it. Like, even though it's a banana, like, I prefer just the banana, you know? Or, like, just a handful of the pecan nuts. But I don't like all this together with cream and all of this sugar. Like, it smells good. It smells really, really nice. It was, like, cinnamon and stuff. It smells awesome, but I don't want it. Like, just the banana would do me. Meh. So, you know. And then, like, I made my dinner, which was this. Now, I know that you can't really see the potato that's in it, but trust me, there's some baked potatoes in there. And the cheese sauce that you can see is potatoes and carrots as well. There's a lot of salad there. I kind of went overboard with making the sauce. I think I made a little bit too much, maybe. Like, essentially, my idea for it was, I want a salsa that isn't spicy. I want something that's a little bit different. And one of the sauces that I had bought was like cigüeña, I want to say. Hang on, let me get the bottle. This sauce that I made, I used shashlik. My pronunciation's terrible. Shashlik sauce, which is sort of like a really, really mild, kind of sweet pepper-based sauce. I have no idea what it is in other countries. Over here, it's shashlik, which I'll type on the screen there. It's like a Middle Eastern sort of Lebanese sauce, I think. Like, I think I've had, like, stuff like that from a takeaway place before that was Lebanese. But yeah, like, I took a tiny bit of that sauce and threw it in a pan after I'd caramelized, you know, just like by cooking them themselves. I sauteed some red onions, some green and red pepper, and then threw in some chunked cherry tomatoes and cucumber, if you believe that, followed by a little bit of this shashlik sauce, and then a bunch of water to, like, make more sauce. Because I didn't want to add too much sugar in or anything from the sauce, so, like, you know, diluted a bit. And then just kept stirring that round up until it thickened up a little bit. And that was awesome. Like, I've got another portion of that. And that is, like, Rowan, why? Okay, you two are just weird. Like, strange animals and humans and babies. Rowan, come out of there. Yeah, so, like, I made the sauce, and I've got another portion of it still. But, yeah, it was really, like, it was sweet. It was a little bit tangy. It wasn't spicy. Because everything that I've eaten, pretty much, every single time that I've added sauce to something, it's been, like, sriracha or, like, sweet chili or something spicy. Or I've made, like, a chili that has a load of pepper in it. Like, I like spicy food, don't get me wrong. I really like spicy food. But, like, for some reason, I just felt like something different today. I just felt like having, like, something that was really mild. And you know what? It worked perfectly. Like, with the amount of salad and stuff, like, it was awesome. I do think that I went a little bit overboard on the amount of salsa. But, you know, like, things happen, and it's all low-carb stuff anyway. It's, like, tomatoes and cucumber and, you know, it's not like more starch or, you know, like avocado, which we're not allowed anyway at the minute. So, well, and I don't like. There's that too. But, yeah, like, it was quite nice. So, oh dear. Right, okay. Well, that was that anyway. And that was the entire day long. I did get a little bit tempted to have an Oreo, but, you know, like, I'd actually had a discussion with Brian and Jessica, and I told them that it was, like, you know, I'd been feeling frustrated because of the amount of progress that I've made on the Mary's Mini compared to my normal sort of diety sort of time, I think it was Brian who said, well, you do realize you were eating Oreos every now and again. I'm like, yeah, I was, but like only like three or four at a time, like in a day, and not every single day. Like, I know that it did ramp up a bit at some point. I was eating like four a day, but then like I cut it back, and you know, like I was still losing. It was just like a much slower sort of curve. And now that I've switched to this Mary's Mini, like it, and cut out everything, it's gone down faster again. So, yeah, he's got a point. But, you know, swallow the water if that's what you've got. Like, yeah, he's got a point, but, you know, like, I don't know. I didn't think that the little cheats that I was allowing myself were that bad, but given the evidence that I've got available, evidently they were. So, I don't know. I think there's discussion between all of us, like the three of us that are doing it. I you know, like Dave is doing his own thing. I don't think he's messaged us about it or anything. He's just decided to join in at the same time, and you know, because he's like a nice guy, I just like say his name as well. But yeah, like there's a bit of discussion about keeping it up, the Mary's Mini, to possibly day 14, because then it's a nice round 2 weeks. There's a little bit more discussion about keeping going for 18 days, because then it takes us up to someone's birthday, like for Brian and Jessica, because then they go along and they celebrate and stuff. And I'm like, I can't really argue with the progress that we're all making. Like, we're all doing pretty good. And keeping that going would be really, really nice. But at the same time, oh, a cheat day, you know? Or even just having some, like, squeezed orange juice or something. Like, you know, just something that little bit, like, different to bring us out of this sort of thing. And then go straight back into it. That would be really good. But I don't know. I mean, it's close enough to the end now where I should really think about what I'm going to do with that. Am I going to carry on for another 4 days at the end of day 10? Dunno. Am I going to join in with those two and carry on up until like day 18? I don't know. I need to think about it. I need to talk about it a little bit more. I need to, you know, run it over in my head. Because it's going well and it's going absolutely fine. I've got no problem really with continuing it. It's just, I would like to, you know, sort of say, like, it was a 10-day thing, I finished the 10-day program, here's a day back to, like, my normal eating, and then we go back into it. But I know that a day off from it might not necessarily work out well. I don't know. I'm gonna have to think about it. Right. I have now waffled on for close to half an hour. I'm definitely going to cut out a bunch of stuff. Hopefully it'll come out to less than half an hour when I've finished. But, you know, such is life. This is the danger of vlogging in the morning when I've got energy. Yay. Right. Thank you very much for joining me. Hope you're enjoying following along with myself and with Brian and Jessica. And, yeah. See you later on today for day number 9 of the mini. Have a good one. Bye-bye.